What are we seeing in terms of your demand? Because there almost seems to be a kind of a big sigh of relief. We're out of the crisis, but we don't know where the growth is coming. What are your order books looking like? How are the travelers in your hotels?
Our business is actually quite strong. The demand is quite good. We saw very good results for 2012. We're off to a good start in 2013. If we look at our advanced bookings, which are a great indicator of what's going to show up throughout the first, second quarter in the year, they're up in a pretty material way. So every part of the world's a little bit different, and I'm kind of aggregating the whole world. The U.S. is and Asia Pacific are sort of leading the charge in terms of growth and demand in our business. Europe is further behind, but still showing positive growth. So overall, we're pretty positive on what's going on in the business from a demand point of view. The other part of our business is just economics, right? So demand is growing, not as robustly as, of course, we would want, but it's growing. But particularly in the Western world, the supply side, the addition of new hotel rooms into the supply side is very, very low. And in the U.S., it's at historical low levels. So you match up fairly reasonable demand with very, very low supply, and you have that positive delta provides very, very reasonable same-store growth in our business.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about with Ken Rogoff of Harvard. One of the big black eyes in the global economy, particularly a Western issue right now, is the rising unemployment rate. We're still at nearly in the Eurozone at 12%. What I find interesting as an industry and as a company, you've come here to Davos to say we have a solution if we just actually have some flexibility and the right training skills. You're talking about creating 75 million jobs. What time frame for the industry are you looking at here?
Travel and tourism, we think over the next 10 years will generate 75 million new jobs. A lot of those jobs are going to be in the emerging markets. One of the things that we're very focused on, both societally and in the sense of a business necessity, is making sure that the youth, particularly 15 to 24-year-olds, have the basic life and work skills that put them in a position where they can come in at an entry level in our hotels. If you look at the emerging markets, overall youth unemployment today is about 13%. But if you go into many of the emerging markets, that's double or triple that level. And those are the very markets where we're seeing the exponential growth.
So what is the solution here? What are you suggesting?
So I think the solution is, there are probably three different things that we're working on. One is education, making sure that, the youth know about opportunities in travel and tourism, and making sure that they know that there's a future, meaning you can come in at an entry level like I did in the business, and you can
go all
the way to the top eventually. So education is one thing. Strategies. So working with civil society, the NGOs, working with governments, and working with industry on pre-employment strategies, because we can't, there's not much we can do to teach basic life skills once they come to hotel. They need to have those basic skills. So it's working in partnership. So
it's almost like changing the mindset in governments to say vocational training is important.
It is. Well, it's vocational training, but it's basic life skills. I mean, in many of the emerging markets, the basics of literacy, numeracy, basic communication skills, basic understanding of the difference between right and wrong, the basic understanding when you have a job, you show up on time. I mean, these things that that in the Western world we in many ways take for granted and sort of as part of a more formal education system don't really exist in the same way in many of the emerging markets. So we can do a certain amount for that. The way we're doing it is really partnering with organizations like IYF, International Youth Foundation, where I serve on the board, and many others throughout the world to really work with local communities to help with basic life skills and basic work skills. Once we get them inside our doors and they have that basic skill set, we have an amazing system of developing our people. We've been doing this for 100 years, and we've been always the pioneer in going into all of the emerging markets for the last 100 years. So when we get them in, I think we have an amazing ability to develop our people, give them a great line of sight to something better. But that we need to work in collaboration with NGOs and with governments to make sure that they are capable of coming.
No, I understand your point. We have about 30 seconds. I wanted to get your thoughts as a U.S. corporation, but operating globally. Do you have grave concerns that this gulf between the Republicans and the White House will not provide an actual meaningful solution? I'm not talking about a 3-month extension to the debt ceiling, but a meaningful solution to get growth back on track?
I do have serious concerns. I mean, the truth of the matter is the foundation, I think, is there for reasonable growth in the U.S. economy. If you look at what's going on with corporate profits and capital spending and general housing markets, et cetera.
Even but shale gas coming
shale
on
gas. Well, there's a lot of ways that, you know, consumer confidence, employment numbers are coming around. But what we really need to start to try and accelerate that momentum is certainty, right? We need to kind of get the uncertainty associated with the debt ceiling and these things out of the way. And that is only going to occur through compromise. So I'm very concerned about it, and I would say I'm hopeful. I'm not a politician. I'm a business guy, but I'm hopeful
that
It's time to move. We've raised the taxes, right? So we've kind of created the sources, and now we need to focus on the uses. So the spending side of it, to kind of have a what everybody's been talking about, which is a balanced equation to create a secure fiscal future for the country. If we do that, I think we are really poised to see a very good acceleration in the growth rate.
If this is put to rest,
we create some certainty so that consumers start to feel better about being able to spend and not worry about what's going to happen tomorrow, and businesses start to, you know, break their piggy banks a little bit because they feel more certain about the future and will increase capital spending, et cetera.
Nice to have you.
Yeah, great to be here.
Chris Mazzetta, once again, the president, chief executive officer of Hilton Hotels.